Hi, everyone. This is TJ from Avid, and welcome back to MBox Studio. In our last video, we looked at the controls and I/O options of MBox Studio, and in this video, we're going to take a look at MBox Control, which is the software application that gives you access to the preferences, effects, and low-latency monitor mixing so that you can create the perfect monitoring situation for your talent at any point. That being said, let's go ahead and jump into this software and see what it has to offer. When installing your software, MBox Control will be a separate application that you will need to install. Once you have it installed and the MBox Studio connected to your computer, press the MBox button on the interface and that will open the application on your computer. Pressing the button again at any point will close the application. Once open, there are several sections to the MBox Control software. The top row is the toolbar. This is where you have access to the interface preferences, signal flow diagram, software access to the tuner and loopback functions, user action buttons, external switch and expression pedal assignments, setting the internal mixer modes, and access to presets for your system. The presets allow you to set up and recall different mixer settings with effects, levels, and routing. Pressing the presets button brings up the presets window. That will give you access to user, factory, and favorite presets. To the right of the window, you have buttons to load, overwrite, save as new, delete, rename, or add to favorites. Load will open the currently selected preset and overwrite all the current settings. Overwrite will replace the data in the selected preset with the current settings. Save as new will let you save the current settings as a new user file. Delete will delete the currently selected preset file. Rename lets you change the name of the currently selected preset file. And add to favorites lets you take a user or factory preset and add it to your favorites list. The mix mode button lets you change mixing modes and monitor preferences of the software. Standard mix mode is on by default. This mode gives you a separate mix for each hardware monitor output. Advanced mix mode gives you access to a hidden mixer control to affect common input controls when no monitor output is selected. The group all monitor mixes mode sends one mix to all the monitor outputs, and mirror main to SPDIF mode takes the main output and duplicates it on the SPDIF output. The four user action buttons let you make custom assignment to the corresponding switches on the MBox Studio front panel. These can be any of several internal actions, such as bringing up the preferences, turning on and off parameters of a selected internal mixer channel, and even access to menus and functions within other preference windows. The buttons are also dual action, in that one action can be invoked with a single short press, and another can be set to trigger with a longer press. Each switch can also have its own custom color. Next are the assignments to the external switch jacks on the rear of the interface. Either of these can be set to work with an expression pedal, on-off, or momentary switch. These can control anything from MIDI plugin parameters to internal actions of the interface itself. Loopback enables you to take input channels 7 and 8 from the internal mixer and route them back to ADAT input 7 and 8 for recording back into Pro Tools or another DAW from other applications on your computer, such as conferencing software like Zoom for podcasters. The Tune button brings up the MBox Studio Tuner right from within the MBox Control software. Current clock source and sample rate are displayed in this area, as well as access to a signal flow chart from the question mark button. And the gear icon brings up the preferences for the software and hardware. Here you can set the clock source and sample rate of MBox Studio, format setting for the optical I/O, pre or post metering of the software mixer, meter ballistic preferences, monitor and headphone preferences, high Z and ground lift selection for the reamp output and effect sends, and hardware light and meter preferences. Below the toolbar are the internal mixer sections. These consist of the hardware input mixer controls, the software input mixer controls, and the hardware output controls. The hardware input mixer consists of mixer channels for all the MBOX Studio hardware inputs. These include the analog inputs and effects returns, Bluetooth, SPDIF, and ADAT digital inputs. Each has an output level control, solo and mute, as well as pan controls. There is a small circle at the bottom of each channel for enabling stereo pairs of odd-even channels. Option on Mac or Alt on Windows, clicking a parameter, will set it back to its default value. And if you double-click on a channel, you can switch between normal and compact views. Each input channel can also access more controls via the channel focus on the left of the mixer. Here you have access to an analog channel's input selection, phantom power, variable Z, pad, high pass filter, soft limiting, and phase. Soft limiting, in particular, is a great little feature for analog inputs because it rounds off all those spiky transients when it's enabled. You also have access to enabling a 4-band EQ in this section that can be used for input monitoring or enabled to record to your DAW. We're going to utilize this later on a guitar track recorded through a DI. There's also a send for the built-in delay and reverb to monitor high-quality effects with the low-latency monitor mixer. Click on the Avid Effects tab to access the delay and reverb controls. The software input mixer controls the 8 channels coming from Pro Tools or other applications. These can be set as mono or stereo pairs. Typically, channels 1 and 2 are linked as a stereo pair and are used as the main stereo outputs of Pro Tools and other DAWs. The output mix for each channel is selected by clicking on a hardware output channel at the bottom of the window. The fader caps change color to indicate the selected hardware output being affected, so it's very easy to just select what output you want and quickly set up the mix. Note that this is for level only. Solo, mute, pan, EQ, and effect sends are global controls to all outputs simultaneously. So, for example, if you select headphone 1, the faders change to a cyan color, and you can then set up a low latency mix from any of the hardware inputs or software inputs that correspond to the outputs from Pro Tools. If you then select headphone 2, the faders turn a blue color, and a totally different low latency mix can be set for that output. Internal mixes can be set up for any of the hardware output channels. And when you select the Avid Effects tab in the channel focus area, the faders change to a purple color. And now you have access to all the channel sends to these effects. In the bottom left-hand corner of the window is the monitor control section. This is a software replication of the monitor controls on the front panel of the MBOX Studio hardware. Here you can select the monitor output destination, set the selected monitor level, link the monitor outputs, mono, mute, and dim the selected monitor output. TalkBack can be activated as well as setting the dim level and overall TalkBack mic gain. It should be noted that the TalkBack level can actually be set independently for each of the hardware outputs within the TalkBack channel in the hardware input mixer section. A nice feature of the MBOX Control app is that the monitor controls can be pulled up as a floating window that will float on top of all applications, giving you access to the monitor section controls no matter what application you're working in. MBOX Control gives you deep access into setting up MBOX Studio for all your workflow needs. We're going to be going into this in more details in future videos, so make sure you join us for those. Thanks so much for hanging out with us, and we'll catch you next time.